Welcome to The Secret Life of the Moon Jelly, Aurelia Arita. Believe it or not, what you are looking at are, in fact, sea jellies. All of the orange structures on this plate are called polyps. It is the second stage in the jelly life cycle. You may notice that some of the polyps are longer than others. That is because they are cloning themselves. They are going through asexual reproduction. Before sea jellies reach this polyp stage, they start their lives out as fertilized eggs, which then begin to swim around as planula. What you see are polyps getting ready to strobulate, meaning they are about to bud off like tiny little flower petals. This third stage in the jelly life cycle is known as ephyrae. While the polyps are strobulating, you might see a few ephyra already swimming in the water. Sea jellies move with a combination of self-propulsion and water flow. Just like other planktonic animals, they go where the water takes them. As the ephyrae grow, they develop their iconic bell shape and become juvenile sea jellies, known as medusae. At this point, the medusae that are ready to graduate are separated from the rest of the ephyrae. Although tiny, this medusa is fully formed. It has all four stomachs and four gonads, which are the orange structures that you see. It also has all of its stinging cells. Sea jellies are almost as simple as they appear. They are mostly made of water, and they have no brains, hearts, or blood. To survive, sea jellies use water instead of blood to move nutrients around in their bodies. They also rely heavily on their stinging cells to capture their prey. When the medusae become too big for this exhibit, we move them into their next home. As the new moon jellies enter the water, you might notice that they look a little bit different than the ones in the water already. That is because all four of their stomachs are full of shrimp, and in this case, they are called brine shrimp, also known as artemia. Moon jellies will also eat other types of crustaceans, as well as other types of zooplankton, meaning animals that float in the water. As these jellies continue to consume more brine shrimp and grow, they will eventually become too large for the curator's lab exhibit. We will then move them into the kelp forest exhibit that has the iconic blue lights and the largest jellies in the science center. Thanks for watching our deep dive into the secret life of the moon jelly. Hope to see you soon!